SpaceX's strongest engine, the Raptor engine, will be used to power SpaceX's next-generation rocket, Starship, which has been in development for the past several years. But now, the Raptor engine is on the verge of completion of its development. SpaceX's Raptor engine production is approaching one engine every 48 hours, stated by Elon Musk on Twitter about a month ago. Though it's an impressive production speed, but not enough to achieve Elon's ultimate goal of colonizing Mars. So, he plans for a second Raptor engine factory along with the Hawthorne factory in California. He stated on Twitter, "We are breaking ground soon on a second Raptor factory at SpaceX Texas Test Site, which is SpaceX's MacGregor test facility, which is also used for research and development of new rocket engines and thrusters, as well as for testing numerous rocket components. This MacGregor factory will focus on volume production of Raptor 2 engines, which is the upgraded and more powerful version of the existing Raptor engine. About 29 to 33 of these Raptor 2 engines will power SpaceX's Super Heavy booster, and about 3 of these engines will power Starship spacecraft, along with 3 or 6 Raptor vacuum engines." He also stated, "While the California factory will mount Raptor vacuums and new experimental designs. By volume production, I mean 2 to 4 engines per day. Roughly 800 to 1,000 per year. That's about what's needed over 10 years to create the fleet to build a self-sustaining city on Mars. City itself probably takes roughly 20 years, so hopefully it is built by around 2050. Raptor 2 production could be extraordinarily efficient and would easily outpace any other large liquid engine production in history at 800 to 1,000 engines completed each year. Technically, at its peak in the 1970s and 1980s, the Soviet Union was producing hundreds of R-7 Soyuz booster engines annually and upwards of over 1,000 per year if one counts the several different kinds of engines on each R-7 Soyuz booster. However, the annual production of a single variant of any other large liquid rocket engine in history has never come close to the targets set out by Musk for SpaceX's Raptor 2 factory. This factory will enable SpaceX to build over 100 Starships and some Super Heavy boosters annually. But building this factory will not be an easy task. Even it will be more difficult than designing the Raptor engine itself." Elon said, "The extreme difficulty of scaling production of new technology is not well understood. It's 1,000% to 10,000% harder than making a few prototypes. The machine that makes the machine is vastly harder than the machine itself." Fortunately, Elon had a lot of practice and experience from Tesla, and Tesla also builds machines that will build the machines for other companies. Last year, Elon confirmed Tesla was working on a vaccine printer for CureVac. So in the future, Tesla and their engineers may also design robotic machines and production line for the Raptor engine volume production. Elon also said MacGregor Raptor 2 engine factory will be the highest outputter and most advanced rocket engine factory in the world. "This most advanced rocket engine factory will use artificial intelligence systems and autonomous robotics along with 3D printing systems to manufacture Raptor engines faster and more efficiently." SpaceX has been using 3D printing for a long time to build its early engines and experimental engines. Various components of early Raptor prototypes were manufactured using 3D printing, including turbopumps and injectors, with the effect of increasing the speed of development and iterative testing. The 2016 subscale development engine had 40% by mass of its parts manufactured by 3D printing. So in the future, SpaceX might use large 3D printers such as Relativity Space's Stargate 3D printer, which is the largest metal 3D printer in the world, to 3D print some major components of the Raptor engine. Relativity Space used this printer to print their entire rockets. One of the viewers of this channel explained the major disadvantage of 3D printing a rocket and its engines in a comment section of this video. I love to read comments. So, comment down your views about this Raptor engine factory. The disadvantage of a 3D printing rocket engine is the speed of printing. Currently, 3D printers don't print fast enough to cooperate with SpaceX plans to build 2 to 5 engines per day. But if somehow SpaceX increases the speed of fabrication of 3D printers, then the 3D printers will be very useful for SpaceX, as SpaceX's main goal is to reduce the cost of manufacturing a rocket engine. And 3D printing will reduce the amount of labor needed, which results in cost reduction in the production of the Raptor engines. Currently, a single Raptor engine costs about $1 million to manufacture. But when SpaceX will start mass production of these engines, a single engine will cost even less than $230,000. As Elon said on Twitter, Raptor 2 is a major improvement in simplification, while also increasing thrust from around 185 tons to around 230 tons. Long-term goal is engine cost below $1,000 per ton of thrust. If everything goes well as SpaceX planned, this engine will improve the way we travel in space, because the Raptor engine is reusable for thousands of times. So its lifespan will probably be about 25 to 30 years. This powerful engine will power the 120 meters tall Starship launch vehicle, and helps to accomplish Elon Musk's visionary goal of creating a self-sufficient city on Mars in the next 20 years. This well-built engine will also benefit NASA not only to land their astronauts on the moon, but also to establish the moon base. This mighty engine also helps humans to explore new worlds such as the moons of Jupiter and Saturn, and actually sets an exciting future for humans. So I hope you enjoyed my video. Like and share this video. And comment down your thoughts about the video. And subscribe to my channel. If you want to know the plans of SpaceX to build the moon base before building the Mars base, watch this video. And to acknowledge the plans of Relativity Space to compete with SpaceX with their 100% 3D printed Terran rocket, watch this video.